Hey everybody. In this video, we're going to take a look at this 1942 Spiegel Holiday Catalog. And there's the mailman in his truck. There's some little baby dolls. There's some glass Christmas ornaments. And I have some ornaments from this era that are very similar to these bells. Ladies' slippers. Here's one that's got a little bunny rabbit on it. Ladies' shoes, $1.49 and up. There's the $1.49. Even the rest of them are only $2 or $3 a pair. Here's some winter boots and galoshes. I remember my grandfather wearing the boots very similar to this. If I close my eyes right now, I can see him plain as day. Snow on the ground. Him wearing these boots. Knockabout. $2.39. Wow. Lumberjack boots. Oil tanned full grain leather uppers. $7.98. Those boots, I imagine, would cost hundreds of dollars now. Work boots. $2.74. A pair of work boots for under $3. Wow. There's some men's Oxfords. Cap toe. But I have a pair that look pretty much like that. Pipes, smoking pipes, that one looks like the devil. That pipe looks like a wolf. There's a, well, they call it a lounge jacket. You've probably heard it called a smoking jacket. But if you were going to be smoking a pipe or a cigar, a gentleman would put on a jacket like this, and that would help keep the odor of the tobacco off of your clothes. Billfolds. Here's some fountain pens. The brand name is Eversharp. Christmas cards. Gift wrapping sets. Gifts for servicemen. And more gifts for servicemen. Your cigarettes by the carton. Lucky Strike, Old Gold, Camel, Chesterfield. $1.19 per carton. Yeah, that's right, per carton. That's 10 packs, 20 cigarettes in each pack, 200 cigarettes for $1.19. What's a pack of cigarettes cost these days? What is a carton of cigarettes, about $60 or $70? There's a little piggy bank for $1.25. On this page is authentic Indian jewelry from a well-known trading post in the Far West. Gifts for him. So grooming sets and aftershave and stuff. Rings for the ladies, and rings for the guys. There's a ring with a Freemason emblem on it. There's the Knights of Columbus. So yeah, you got some fraternal rings. And some watches. Some little knickknacks. Siamese cats. Colonial bell, some religious things, a vase, more jewelry. I recognize the name Balava. And here's some bath mats, toilet seat covers, hand towels. Some blankets and slip covers for the furniture. Bedspreads. Some quilting. Blankets. Drapes. Every time I hear the word drapes, I think about Carol Burnett from the Carol Burnett Show back in the 70s, doing a skit. It was a comedy show. They were doing a skit about Gone with the Wind. And she had taken the drapes off of the window and fashioned a dress. And someone commented on her dress and where she got it. And she said it was just hanging around. Guess you would have had seen it to appreciate it. Personalized dinnerware. Your own monogram in a handmade crest. There's some famous oven to table dinnerware. Take it straight from the oven, put it on the table. Some Bibles and encyclopedias. A globe. There's some oil heaters. Mohair furniture. That couch and that nice easy chair. That set cost $56. Here's a lounge chair for $26. Wow. And some various home furnishings, lamps, tables. Cedar chest. Mattresses. Bookshelves. A dinette table and chairs. $16. There's a whole bedroom suit for $39. record player, radio. I do like these old radios. Vacuum cleaners. These old vacuum cleaners weighed a ton. Nothing compared to the lightweight vacuums of today. Now we get to the good stuff. 27-piece electric freight train. There's the classic erector set for $2.45. Lincoln Logs. In this catalog, they're called Lincoln Timbers. Various toys. I see a lot of tin vehicles made out of tin, maybe steel, I don't know. Probably some of these items are highly collectible these days. Action and educational toys for 98 cents. Trucks and tractors. Penguins that you bowl down with little bowling balls. Humongous building block set. 49 cents. And to order this stuff, obviously the internet did not exist. You had to fill out the order form. In this example, I'm going to try to zoom in on it. You can see that they used cursive writing to fill it out. And a lot of people, even some of you watching this video, possibly can't read what any of this says. But this says women's slip in men's pajamas and three trumpet musical horn, women's slippers. Fur fabric, something, cotton, sport auto, skating doll, fur chip. So yeah, you had to fill that out, then you had to mail it. Let me recenter the catalog. There. it's a lot different than it is to just hit the pay with PayPal button. Here's some boys' toys. Guns and trucks and tractors and cars. Little toy piano. Some board games. There's Monopoly. $1.79. And there's the little tin cars that the kids could ride around in. So back in 1942, you could buy one of these for about $10. And these days, you've got people practically tripping over themselves to snatch these old examples up and display them, collect them. There's some sleds. I see these and I automatically take a trip back in time in my mind to sledding down the hills in the winter as a child. And here's a little toy. Well, these are dollhouse furniture, I think. Yeah. For the dollhouse. And bicycles for small kids. And tricycles. Scooters. No, they didn't have motors on the scooters back then. Some kids even made their own scooters out of wood. Roller skate wheels, kind of like on Back to the Future when Marty McFly stole the kid's scooter so that he could get away from Biff. Very lifelike, big as a real baby. Some kids' furniture, desk and chalkboards, little chairs, basketballs and roller skates, boxing gloves, ice skates. My dad used to hose down a low area in the backyard and let it freeze. And I used to ice skate on that. And we used to go ice fishing out on the lake. I used to ice skate. I'd fish, but when I got tired of fishing, I used to ice skate all over that lake. Of course, the ice was really, really thick. There was no danger of falling through. The ice was so thick we would drive our car out onto the lake. Christmas lights, Santa Claus outfit. Guitars. Man, it looks like you could buy live chickens. Raised chicks have plenty of fresh meat and fresh eggs. So raise your own chickens. You could get one for 9¾ cents. But you had to buy 100 at one time. Tools. Here's horns and headlights and tire pumps and snow chains for your tires. Various tools, rubber liners for your tires, so typewriters, snow suits, pajamas and robes for men. This guy is eating a sandwich. That guy's taking a drink of something. That guy's got a pipe in his hand. He's got a piece of paper. It's all very colorful. Little uniforms for children. I've got photographs of my dad and about the age of 3 wearing a little uniform kind of like this. Well, actually, I think he was probably 5 or 6 years old. During that time, his big brother, my uncle, was a soldier in World War II. If you've watched my channel, you've probably seen some videos where I've showed you some of the items that used to belong to him that belong to me now. Men's fashion. There's pants for boys back then. So unusual the way they looked, the bagginess of them. Even the men's pants had high waist, very crisp creases in the pants. Large hem, cuffed legs. Coats, jackets. men's clothing, men's suits, that double-breasted jacket is, it's a timeless piece. And of course, back then, most all men wore hats of some form or fashion. Swagger style overcoat, top coat. Yeah, that was all a pretty good look as far as I'm concerned. Yeah, men's long underwear, it looks like, and hats, belts. Here's some of the ladies' fashions. Fur coats. That's quite the hot topic today. And if they weren't real furs, then you had fur-like fabrics. Fluffy, toughy, cuddle coats. Fluffy, toughy, cuddle coats. I don't know why that strikes me as funny, but there's the beloved trench coat. Various dresses. Not sure why all the colors are gray. Have you noticed that? They're gray. And to me, that's about the worst color a dress can be, would be gray. That is about as risque as this catalog is probably going to be. You noticed in the, they use artist drawings for some of the nightwear instead of having real models photographed. How much were those socks? Five pair for $1. Pretty nice looking socks. These days you pay about $50 for that, if not more. Yeah, it's back in the days where men were men. Oh, there's candy corn. There's an order blank for cash orders only. Cash in full must be enclosed with your order. So this is the days you put your money, actual cash money, in the envelope and mailed it off. And this Mrs. Moore, who lived in North Carolina, maybe still alive, was going to order a microscope set and a Gilbert chemical set. And I think that was the last page. Or maybe it wasn't. Let's see if we can read what they wrote here. Gilbert microscope set. Electric phone. There's some kind of something set. Radio set. Hand microphone, xylophone, Daffy pool, sled, archery set, ski outfit. I would think the most important thing here would be to make sure that these catalog numbers are legible. And it seems like you would take great care in time to make sure the numbers were legible. But this person had some horrendous writing. And that's the last page. So I hope you enjoyed this catalog. If you want to see more of this type of video, where we flip through online catalogs, tell me in the comments. And until then...